Bill Snopper here, and if you love big tailgate parties, you'll love the Monster Tailgate Sales Event at Franklin Sussex Auto Mall. With savings up to $10,000 off every new Jeep, Chrysler, Dodge, and Ram. Plus, with every purchase, you'll get a Coleman Excursion Grill. Get savings up to $10,000 off the dream car, truck, SUV you really want. And if you need credit help, we can cook it up for you and serve it well done. For Monster Tailgate Savings, hurry to Route 23 in Sussex.
Jeep Celebration Event, Ram Power Days.
Welcome to a Monday and Tuesday edition of the Franklin Sussex Auto Mall, Franklin Sussex Hyundai Sports Beat, right here on Local Channel 10 and High Definition, mugsmedia.com, now in High Definition, all right, our website, brand new website. We're going to begin this show with Newton, Lenape Valley, big matchup in football. Let's roll the video on that game.
This portion of a Sports Beat, sponsored by Eastern Propane, your local hometown propane dealer. Call 827-3000.
We go to Patriots Field, and after Lenape Valley forces a Newton punt on 3rd and 6, it's quarterback Jay Pruden fighting Stevie Leiden for the first down in Newton territory. Then watch Jay Pruden on the quarterback keep for the 1 yard touchdown run, and Lenape Valley has the 7-0 lead. All right, Newton's on the move, and in 3rd and 5, it's talented junior Chase Kramer on the reverse as he rumbles up the middle for the first down, but Newton trails 7-0 after one quarter. All right, second quarter, same drive, and on 2nd and goal, it's Chase Kramer punching it in, and we're tied at 7. Lenape Valley has the ball back, and Steven Sylvester takes it to the outside. He cuts upfield for this 27-yard run deep into Newton territory. Then it's Troy DuPont starting his big night as he weaves his way in from 2 yards out, and after the missed PAT, Lenape Valley has a 13-7 lead. All right, Lenape Valley coach Don Smullen reaches into his bag of tricks and goes with the onside kick, and it's Kai Dickerson between a bunch of Newton players. He gets the ball, and Lenape Valley has the possession. Big play there. All right, Lenape Valley faces a 4th and 7 and decides to go for it, and Jay Pruden sets up the screen perfectly to Troy DuPont, and he gets just enough for the first down to keep the chains moving. Now watch Lenape Valley facing a 3rd and 4, and they give the ball to Mr. Excitement, Stevie Leiden, who takes it into the end zone from 15 yards out, and the Patriots' two-point conversion fails, but they have a 19-7 lead. All right, Newton's trying to put some points on before halftime, but Tyler Tarnowski steps up in front of the receiver for the pick, and he takes it all the way inside the Braves' 5-yard line. Wow. And Troy DuPont finishes off the drive for Lenape Valley from 3 yards out for his 2nd touchdown, and the Patriots will take a 20-6 lead into the locker room. Opening kickoff, 2nd half, and the ball bounces and stops rolling before crossing into the end zone. Then it's Mr. Excitement again, Stevie Leiden. He casually picks up the ball, and with a burst of speed, he jets 72 yards inside the Newton 30, and Lenape Valley set up again. What a player he is. He's so dynamic. 1st and goal from the 3, and Troy DuPont continues his monster game with his 3rd touchdown of the game, and it's 32-7 Lenape Valley after the missed 2-point conversion. There's no quitting this hard-nosed Newton team. Watch Chase Kramer rumble 9 yards and pick up the 1st down for the Braves. Newton cashes in on this drive as Will Larson on the reverse dives into the end zone for the 23-yard score, and after the 2-point conversion, Newton trails 32-15. Lenape Valley would tack on one more score here on this Drew Pickett 4-yard touchdown run, as Lenape Valley would post the impressive 38-15 victory over Newton as the Pats improved to 1-1 after losing to Madison last week as the Braves dropped to 1-1 in the season.
All started with our line. They created great holes for our running backs, and we just ran right through them.
We performed very well, I think. Coming from last week, you know, we didn't do good on defense, let up 45 points, missed a lot of missed tackles. And our line didn't do the best, but you know, we came back this week, worked really hard in practice, only let them score 15 points, and we scored 38 again. So I think defense really stepped up, and the offensive line really came to play.
A bunch of our kids were banged up, didn't practice till Thursday, you know, because the last week's game was such a emotionally draining game, you know, and to lose one like that. But, you know, this really, it's credit to the kids. I mean, they came back. They practiced great this week. We had a great week of practice, good focus. You know, a bunch of kids contributed tonight, so.
So the energy from this Lenape Valley crowd, it's unreal. They're loud. How much does that motivate you as a player?
I mean, they're the best student section in the county, so I gotta say that. But it's like having a 12th man right there on the field. Like, they're right back with you, and when you make great play, you just hear the rupture.
It's great, especially with the big bobbleheads that we had, which is, I think, is pretty awesome. You know, it really gets us motivated. It gets you pumped. It's the atmosphere of the game, you know. When you hear someone break a big long run, and then you hear the stands going nuts, it's awesome. It's a great feeling.
Going into the locker room at half with such a big lead, was there a challenge to stay focused, or what was the mindset like coming into the third?
No, coach basically told us 0-0 starting the third quarter, and we kind of all went up with that, and we came back the third quarter, and we hit hard, just like we did the first quarter.
What are some goals or milestones you want to achieve with the Parade Tiers this year?
It's all going to MetLife. That's all I want to do, is just be in MetLife.
What areas of the game are you going to focus on improving in next week's practice to be successful again next week?
I'm not excited yet as to where we are defensively. You know, I think we've, you know, for us to make that jump into the playoffs, we're going to have to be better as to compete against, you know, the Mountain Lakes, the Walk Hills, the, you know, the Lakeland schools like that, Hackettstown. We're not where we should be defensively.
What was it like coaching against Coach Parzero, a former player for you and somebody you coached alongside with as well?
It's hard. I mean, Matt's a special person for me. You know, I think anybody who's ever worked for me, you know, there's a special bond. And this is hard, you know, win or lose, you know, and it just, we played him three times now, and my heart goes out to him. You know, it's tough, you know, it's fact of life.
Coach Smolin, year in and year out, you achieve a consistently great football team. What are some of the top qualities you look for in football players?
It's been a four-prong approach, basically. You know, we've got a very supportive community, very good youth program, and an outstanding staff here. Kids come in, I think the number one thing is, you know, are they willing to, you know, be dedicated all year long? You know, I don't care if they play other sports, that's fine, but if you're not involved, you got to be in the weight room. I mean, we pride ourselves in on being able to run the football like you saw tonight, you know, and that's a carryover from the weight room. We want good, solid kids. I want kids who are good in the classroom, you know, good out here.
And then any thoughts on next week's game against Walco Valley?
You know, again, we've got a guy who worked with us for 2 years who's over there coaching as an assistant now, Scotty Nordland. We've always had some barn burners going up there. You know, it just seems like that's just like a little house of horrors for us, you know. So, you know, we got to get them focused back. I know this was a big win tonight for these kids. You know, a lot of these kids grow up playing with these kids and stuff like that, you know. So it's a big deal.
There you have it, folks. Thriller in-division game rivalry between the Newton Braves and Lenape Valley Patriots. Final score being Lenape Valley 38, Newton 15. With Mugs Media, I'm Joe Gascione.
All right, folks, you're watching us on mugsmedia.com in high definition right now. And let me see what else I can pass along to you. Some new information about Mugs Media and mugsmedia.com. You can watch us on, you know, smart TV right now. I want to check that out so I know what I'm doing here. All right. YouTube also is on Xbox, and it's on Apple TV. So, you know, you go to Apple TV, you subscribe to our YouTube page, and you can watch the Sports Beat on high definition, all right? And we'll soon have an app for you to watch the Sports Beat. Just a couple months away. Website is done, it looks beautiful. Modernized, fits the whole screen now. Gotta modernize that website. And speaking of websites, let's say you have a website and it's not doing you any good because you have a picture of your office. Just a picture, nothing. Nobody gets excited about it. Why don't you put a video on there and hire Mugs Media to do that for you? Send me an email, jerry@mugsmedia.com. All right, get with the times, folks. We do social media videos, website videos, promotional videos, and we do recruiting videos if your son or daughter has the ability to play a college athlete, become a college athlete, all right? Don't forget to get on it right away. Let's go. Numbers need to go up. Here at the Auto Mall, the numbers need to go up. You know, at Franklin Sussex Auto Mall, got to buy a car here, new or used vehicle. And, of course, you never have enough business, all right? I'll be at Skyline Stadium this weekend doing the Beer Fest. Can I sample something on there? The car will be going like this, but anyway, I better take a commercial time out.
Bill Snopper here, and if you love big tailgate parties, you'll love the Monster Tailgate Sales Event at Franklin Sussex Auto Mall. With savings up to $10,000 off every new Jeep, Chrysler, Dodge, and Ram. Plus, with every purchase, you'll get a Coleman Excursion Grill. Get savings up to $10,000 off the dream car, truck, SUV you really want. And if you need credit help, we can cook it up for you and serve it well done. For Monster Tailgate Savings, hurry to Route 23 in Sussex.
Jeep Celebration Event, Ram Power Days.
United Water is now Suez, safe, clean water for the communities they serve.
We're extremely excited about our plans to build the region's only dedicated center for breast health, equipped with breast tomosynthesis 3D mammography. Because we know women serve as the healthcare navigators for their families, Newton Medical Center has designated 2015 as the Year of Women's Health. In partnership with the Newton Medical Center Foundation, this year-long celebration will empower and support women with a variety of programs and resources to help them best care for themselves while raising funds to continue our critical mission of providing essential services to women and their families.
I'm Sally Pearson from Dixon Energy. Letters like this one are music to my ears.
Dear Dixon, when our old oil company closed with no warning, I was scared, nervous as a cat in a room full of rocking chairs. I called Dixon for help, and in two shakes of a lamb's tail, heating oil was on its way. Now we're warm as toast, because we finally have a local dealer we can count on.
To be a happy gas or oil customer, call Dixon today.
You know you love pizza and Italian food. Dominic's Pizzeria and Italian Restaurant has got you covered from one end of the county to the other with three great locations. Dominic's, East Clinton Street in Newton, with a brand new dining room. Then there's Dominic's on Munsonhurst Road in Franklin. And the third location is Chesco's, Route 94 South in Newton. All three locations offer simply great food. Dominic's in Newton, 383-9330. Dominic's in Franklin, 209-1007, and Chesco's, 383-2840.
Eastern Propane, since 1938, three generations of a Nicholson family has been serving the area with clean, dependable propane. A lot has changed over the last 75 years, but not the dependability of Eastern Propane. Eastern Propane is and always will be your local hometown propane dealer with their friendly team of customer service and people in the field. Eastern Propane involved in the communities they serve. Eastern Propane, exceptional energy. Call 827-3000.
Sussex County Community College is a great place to branch out and figure out what suits you best and what fits you as an individual.
The array of classes that they offer was perfect.
Professors will go out of their way for you. They'll sit with you until you understand completely.
It was a right choice for me because it would save me money and I would be able to get all my gen eds done before you're moving on to a four-year university.
Visit us at sussex.edu to find out more. Sussex County Community College. Start here, go anywhere.
Welcome back to the Franklin Sussex Auto Mall, Franklin Sussex Hyundai Sports Beat. The game of the week here on Channel 10, Vernon Jefferson, sponsored by your local community bank, Highlands Community Bank. Throughout Northwest New Jersey, they have offices of Vernon and Sparta. They're good people over there, and they're honest people. They're honest bankers. Not like the bank down the street has been in the news lately. By the way, I don't know. I don't want to comment on that. It's not my place. Anyway, let's take a look at the highlights of the Vernon Jefferson game.
These highlights are being brought to you by Rev It Up, Auto and Maintenance Garage on Main Street in Sparta.
We go to Jefferson Township High School, and Vernon is moving on its opening drive. Facing 4th and 3, it's quarterback Brandon Lavarini rolling to his left, and he finds Paul Wenzel for the 15-yard gain and a 1st and goal for the Vikings. Then 3 plays later is Brandon Lavarini on the keeper, and he scores from a yard out. And after the PAT is blocked, Vernon has a quick 6-0 lead. Okay, Jefferson's facing a 3rd and 1, and Vernon shows blitz as Paul Wenzel gets to the quarterback for the sack. And at the 1 quarter play, it's 6-0 Vernon. 2nd quarter we go, and Vernon's looking to pass, but it's Brandon Magnano with the first of his 2 interceptions on the night, and Jefferson takes over at its own 27. The very next play, it's Jalen Torres on the jet sweep, and he bounces to the outside, and he rumbles 73 yards for the touchdown, and with the PAT, Jefferson now has a 7-6 lead. After a Vernon turnover, Jefferson's driving once again, and the offensive line does its part, opening a huge hole for Connor Brown as he goes 19 yards up the middle for the touchdown, and it's 14-6 Jefferson. Jefferson is on the move again, and once again it's Connor Brown with a 17-yard run into Vernon territory. The Falcons would have to settle for a field goal as Andrew Benfoudy knocks down the 22-yard field goal, and Jefferson now leads 17-6. On the ensuing kickoff, Michael Fleming of Jefferson does a great job forcing the fumble, and Paul Monaco scoops it up, and the Falcons are in business with the ball deep in Vernon territory. And Jefferson cashes in the turnover here. Watch Alex Lemming take the jet sweep, and he gets outside. He spins his way into the end zone, and Jefferson has a 23-6 lead at the half. Big play right there. We go to third quarter action, and it's Logan Hollerith finding Brandon Magnotta over the middle, and he goes 59 yards for the touchdown, and Jefferson pushes its lead to 30-6. He is a dynamic player, that Magnotta. The Vikings fought hard all night, and on 3rd and 8, Brandon Lavorini gets it to Mike Stefkovic, who gets the first down for the Vikings. And Vernon caps the 68-yard drive as Brandon Lavorini finds Kevin Parisi, who weaves his way into the end zone, and the Vikings now trail 30-12. Jefferson will go on to score one more time as the offensive line once again opens a huge hole for Brandon Magnotta, who sprints 70 yards to pay dirt as Jefferson soars past Vernon 37-12 to improve to 2-0 on the season as the Vikings fall to 1-1.
It's really exciting. We haven't gone 2-0 our whole high school career, so it's really exciting to get the team together and to go 2-0.
First of all, I gotta say, the linemen played a great game. They had the huge holes, and that's what sparked me. That's all I gotta say.
It was a great game, a great season so far. I hope that we keep firing all cylinders and keep it going.
It was a great team win all around. Everyone was working hard. Everyone was staying together, and we all just stuck to the game plan that coach gave for us, and we just came out on top.
I was impressed with our ability to just stay calm, cool, and collective. Vernon came out swinging right away. Was able to punch one in and had a nice first drive on us. But the kids just stuck to the game plan, just continued to grind, never gave up, and played four quarters.
Brandon Magnotta had a magnificent night tonight on both sides of the ball. He had two interceptions, one set up a touchdown. He had a 69-yard touchdown run to start the third quarter to get them going. And he also caught a touchdown pass from Logan Hollerith for 59 yards. What a game.
I was just trying to spark something going. On the second pick, I was just trying to take it. I cut too early.
Brandon's a special player. He always has been. And I think his maturation process, throughout his high school career, up until his senior year now, what we talked about, not only with him, but with everybody, is just staying consistent. Don't be too high when you're high. Don't be too low when you're low. Continue to go out and grind and prepare every single day, and that consistency will lead to good things.
Vernon came out, had a 6-0 lead, controlled the ball in the first quarter, got off to a great start, but Jefferson's defense got it together. They allowed another touchdown, but they really took control, and they said it was all because of their new mindset after they gave up the touchdown to Vernon.
We are a second-half team, but we knew that every team comes here and they get hyped up on the first drive, and we know that if we keep working them, we'll be all right, and our whole team just stuck it together.
It was our mindset. Our coach always tells us that next play is the best play, best play is next play, whatever, and we just kept our mind good and just went on.
Jefferson came back and took a 7-6 lead after an interception by Brandon Magnotta. Then Jalen Torres took it to the house for 78 yards.
I saw an open hole. Our line blocked great. Everything just went perfect, and it was a perfect play.
Big play in this game. After Jefferson had taken a 17-6 lead on a field goal by Andrew Benfoudy, Vernon fumbled the kickoff. Then Alexander Lemming took it in before the end of the half with a nice touchdown run, and it was 23-6, and Jefferson was in charge.
That was actually huge for us because we need a lot of momentum coming into half, because sometimes we can come out slow coming out of halftime. So I was just thinking we have to get in, and our line just did everything, and I barely had to even work and just walked in.
Anytime you can get a back-to-back score that quick right before the half, and then we came out. And then we came out in the second half with the ball, and we were able to punch up another one. That's kind of like having three scorers all back to back to back. That's tough to deal with, at any level, really.
This Jefferson team has so many weapons. We saw that tonight. Jalen Torres, Alexander Lemming, Connor Brown, Jacob Jacoba, all these kids, Brandon Magnotta. So they spread the wealth here in this offense, and the Falcons have been very effective.
We spread the ball around very well, so no team knows or can key on anybody. And we just take it week by week, and every week a new kid has a better game than he did the last game.
I love it. I love the fact that we have so many weapons, keeps our legs fresh. Whenever Magnotta or Lennon comes down, I'm always tapping him on the helmet, saying, let's go, let's get it, and I love it.
Last year, we didn't use all these weapons. That's why we were 5-5, and now we're using all these weapons. Now Lennon got his first touchdown. Torres got his first touchdown. Me and Connor both got touchdowns. Like, it's great. We're spreading the wealth, and it was just great all around.
Anytime when you have a senior heavy team, you know, it's always great to see different kids step up and make plays, you know, week in and week out. You know, if it's not Brandon, it's Jalen or Alex or Connor. And, you know, you got Jacoba, you know, leading the defense. And up front, I can't say enough about those linemen really on both sides of the ball. You know, we always talk about winning at the line of scrimmage, you know, at the first level. And if it's not for them, we don't do what we do. So I'm really proud of those guys up front.
Jefferson's played two games at home, two victories over High Point and Vernon. Now they'll get their first road test against a very good Mendham team.
Mendham's always had a really solid reputation. You know, we'll enjoy this one tonight, and we'll get to work tomorrow, you know, and think about Mendham then.
Mendham's a good team. We got to get back at it tomorrow and enjoy the win.
We just got to go out, prepare during practice, during the week, watch a lot of film, and just get ready.
Road game, it's going to be tough. It's a little different for us. We're used to our home crowd. We're going to have to really get the guys up and practice and work extra hard.
We never played Mendham before, so it's going to be an experience, but we got to just take it week by week. We'll prepare for them all week.
All right, folks, we're now in high definition. You can watch us on Apple TV, Smart TV. Go to YouTube and subscribe to our YouTube. And you can watch us on high definition TV on our website, mugsmedia.com. And coming soon, we'll have an app, a special Sports Beat app. Hear that, Bill Snoffer? We're updating your advertising. Should we charge them more? No. Mugs, get out of here. As the foot goes flying through, I come flying through the window there at the Auto Mall. Anyway, you're watching the Franklin Sussex Auto Mall, Franklin Sussex Hyundai Sports Beat. Let's take a commercial timeout.
Bill Snoffer here, and if you love big tailgate parties, you'll love the Monster Tailgate Sales Event at Franklin Sussex Auto Mall. With savings up to $10,000 off every new Jeep, Chrysler, Dodge, and Ram. Plus, with every purchase, you'll get a Coleman Excursion Grill. Get savings up to 10 grand off the dream car, truck, SUV you really want. And if you need credit help, we can cook it up for you and serve it well done. For Monster Tailgate Savings, hurry to Route 23 in Sussex.
Jeep Celebration Event, Ram Power Days.
Hi, my name is Sheriff Mike Strada. If you have information relating to crime in Sussex County, please call our hotline at 973-300-CRIME or visit our website at www.sussexcountysheriff.com. If your tip leads to an arrest, you could receive an award of up to $1,000 and you also remain anonymous. Thank you.
This message made possible by D&H Risk Solutions. For more information, go to risksolutions.com.
Looking for the perfect sure-to-please gift? Visit Gala Florist, conveniently located in the Jefferson Diner Plaza, offering expert floral design for all occasions, everything from a beautiful bouquet of roses to stunning wedding flowers. Gala Florist also offers a wide selection of seasonal gifts, plants, fruit and gourmet baskets, handbags, and jewelry. Gala Florist combines artful arrangements with the freshest flowers, exceptional service, and worldwide delivery. Come shop Gala Florist next to the Jefferson Diner or visit online at galaflorist.com. Gala Florist, 973-288-1847.
Winter, spring, summer, fall. For over 75 years, Eastern Propane is and always will be your local hometown propane dealer. Propane is clean, dependable energy. Eastern Propane, three generations of the Nicholson family. Eastern Propane is proud to support the student-athletes of Northwest New Jersey. Eastern Propane, your local hometown propane dealer. Call 827-3000. Betts has been providing turnkey remediation contracting and environmental consulting for over 25 years. Betts owns and operates a full-service fleet of excavation and construction equipment that enables us to provide in-house services for both small and large-scale projects. If you're in need of due diligence, environmental consulting,
or LSRP services, call Betts Environmental today.
Pop, 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 money, money. Pop, 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 money, money, money.
Use your phone to pay your friends. You can even pay the rent. Out to dinner, pay your buddy. Use your phone to pop your money.
Lakeland Banks, pop money, money. Pop, 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 money, money, money.
Pay the sitter, send the gift. It's real easy, you get my drift. You don't need checks, you don't need cash. Use pop money, it's so fast.
Lakeland Banks, pop money, money. The easy way to pay people. Pop to it.
Pop, pop, pop.
Welcome back to the Franklin Sussex Auto Mall, Franklin Sussex Hyundai Sports Beat here on Local Channel 10. Well, I guess Kittatinny went the back way and up to 15 down to beautiful Dover, New Jersey to play the other way. Dover went to Kittatinny. Oh, okay, so Dover had to come up 15. All right. Well, the game was at Kittatinny, and we have some highlights of that game. Let's check it out.
This portion of a Sports Beat is sponsored by Tire King behind the AMP in Sussex, where everyone can afford to retire. Tire King now does brakes as well. Tire King, tell Charles Caparis Muggsy sent me. Walk in there and yell out, Tire King. The phone number is 875-5950.
First quarter action here at Romer Field at Kittatinny on Hall of Fame Day, and the Cougars pick up the first down here. Watch Jack Sikora shake the defender and rumble 14 yards to the Dover 19. Then watch this incredible run by Josh Klimek as he gets around the end. He stays on his feet. Is the play over? No, watch Klimek keep going, and he scores a 16-yard touchdown, and Kittatinny has a 6-0 lead. What a run! Kittatinny comes out fired up on defense. Watch Justin Modafferi break through for the big loss of 4 yards, forcing a Dover punt. Then watch Modafferi do it again for Kittatinny with another tackle for a loss, this time for 5 yards, and Kittatinny has a 6-0 lead after one quarter of play. Second quarter we go, and it's Kittatinny quarterback Nick Geimer feeling the pressure, and he breaks the tackle, and watch him take off for this terrific 33-yard gain, tack on a Dover face mask, and Kittatinny has it 1st and 10 at the Dover 21. That run would set up this 33-yard field goal attempt by freshman Gianluca Torri. It's up, and it hits the upright, but it goes in for the 33-yard field goal. Wow! And Kittatinny has a 9-0 lead with 7:27 to go here in the quarter. The Cougars get the ball back and watch Josh Klimek follow his blockers and take it up the sidelines for 32 yards and a first down before he's knocked out at midfield. Then watch Nick Geimer look to pass. He tosses it up, and watch Jack Sikora go up and get it and make the catch, but he steps out of bounds, so it's not a touchdown, but it is a 19-yard gain and a first down at the Dover 31. Okay, here's a wild play. Watch Kittatinny run the ball. The ball pops out, and it's sophomore Zach Mafaro with his first varsity touchdown with the 12-yard scoop and score, and Kittatinny takes a 16-0 lead after the PAT, and that is our score at the half. What a play. All right, third quarter we go, and Dover's on the move. Watch quarterback Christian Acevedo get it to Mason Sanchez for the well-designed screenplay, and he picks up 33 yards all the way down to the Kittatinny 10. And the Tigers cap the drive here. Watch Acevedo hit a wide-open to Shea Wilfong, who cuts it up, and he scores from 10 yards out. And Dover trails 16-6 with 4:04 left in the third quarter. And that is our score as we head to the fourth quarter. All right, fourth quarter action. Here is the biggest play of the game. Watch Nick Geimer make the perfect read, make the pick, and he takes it to the house for the 73-yard touchdown. And Kittatinny pushes its lead to 23-6 with 8:05 to go. Big play there. And that was big because watch Dover make it 23-13 here as Christian Acevedo zips it to Zarius Nieves, who shakes the defender and raises in from 25 yards out for the touchdown, and it's a 10-point gain with 7:13 to go. Kittatinny would eat some clock, but they return the ball over, which allows Dover to cash in here on fourth and goal from the 9. It's a touchdown pass from Acevedo to Francisco Arenas, but there's only 3 seconds left as Kittatinny will hold on for the wild 23-20 victory, their first of the season after falling to Newton opening day.
Last week, you know, it was upsetting. We got spanked by Newton, and, you know, we came back, we worked our, you know, our butts off, and we wanted to smack someone else, you know, for a change. And it's an opener, alumni, you know, it was a big day for us. It was a big day. We're excited. We worked hard this week, and, you know, we came out on top.
We had the big crowd here today. We wanted to impress them, but after last week's loss, we all just sat together and thought, well, we can't have what we did last week again, where we just gave up, and this week we just kept on going, didn't give up, and each play was just another great play. We, you know, yeah.
I think our line really played well. We played well as a team. Got a little scary there at the end, but we stuck it out. We blocked. We finished. We executed. Great, good win.
Feels good. You know, we bounced back off the loss to Newton, and, you know, there was no better place to get a win rather than your home field, Hall of Fame game, and a big crowd.
I'm just happy for our kids. You know, they worked hard all week. You know, a little down after last week at Newton. Kids came back, worked hard all week, got better as the week went on, and I'm just really happy for them today. Get back to 1-1. Big for us.
Kittatinny scored first in this one on a terrific run, a play of the week nominee from Josh Klimek as he refused to go down. Whistle, everyone thought might have been blown, but it wasn't. He got the big touchdown. Kittatinny had the early lead.
I came out, and, you know, we hit contact, and they kind of like stopped driving their feet almost. So, you know, I kept going, and then one guy wrapped up on my leg. Next thing I knew, I was, you know, close to the sideline. I put my arm down and, you know, chugged my foot out of his hands and ran into the end zone, and they thought I was down. But
one of the storylines of this game was big plays. Klimek's play. Nick Geimer had a pick six. Zach Mufaro, a scoop and score, and their field goal went off the post and went in.
We had a lot of big plays. You know, last week it was new with the big plays, but we decided to make some. You know, I have, you know, one big run. It was open, you know, my guard pulled, led through a block. You know, it was a beautiful play. You know, it worked out perfectly. And then, you know, I'm running again, and I fumble the ball. You know, I'm trying to get to it. It's bouncing off people. Thank goodness Mufaro was there to scoop it up and take it in for me, because, you know, it's, you know, Nick Geimer, you know, covering that curl. You know, we were hoping, we're like, you know, Geimer, big plays here, big plays. You know, he rolls out in the curl. Geimer takes it, and he's gone. He's so fast, no one's catching him.
Those big plays can make or break the game, and we had those plays. I honestly thought Josh was out of bounds or down, and he just made it in the end zone. I'm surprised by that. My pick six was good. Zach scoop and score, and then that kick. Just all these big plays can make a big difference in a football game.
We got a couple breaks go our way today, but that's football. You know, sometimes they go your way, and sometimes they don't. But our kids never quit playing, and that's how Josh got in down here. And, you know, Zach had the presence to pick up the football after Josh fumbles down this end, scoops and scores his first touchdown on a scoop and score on the offense. So, you know, yeah, a couple things went our way, but, you know, sometimes they go your way, and sometimes they don't. We'll take it.
Nick Geimer is a great quarterback, but also a terrific defensive back. He knew Dover was in a passing situation. He read it perfectly and took it back to the house for a touchdown.
I saw that they had the two guys on the wide out there. So the one guy was running a slant, and then I saw the other guy on the wheel, and the quarterback opened up right to him. So I knew the ball was going right to him, and I decided to just go for it, and it just worked in my favor.
Zach Mufaro is a terrific young talent, just a sophomore. He got his first career touchdown on a scoop and score off a fumble by the Cougars.
At first I was blocking, then I looked down and I see the two big guys from Dover fall on it, and it, you know, it popped out, and my first reaction was, you know what, I'm going to pick it up and I'm going to try and run as far as I could, and it just ended up working out.
Dover's got a massive offensive and defensive line. Kittatinny undersized, but their linemen played great. One of their seniors, Josh McMillan, anchors that line.
Oh, I love it, because you know they're going to finish the run. If you block their guy, they're going to run through people just to get to the end zone. They're going to play their hearts out. It's great.
Kittatinny knew about the two big guys in the middle for Dover, so they tried to get the edge, and that game plan worked.
That was our game plan all week. We have like 130 pounds total up on the front of the line in the middle, so we're not going to run right up front. So run around them. They're slow. We're going to punch them in the mouth, and we're just going to keep pushing downfield and get to the outside and just run it.
They did a wonderful job blocking. You know, you can't run if they're not blocking, and you know, they held their own against those big guys, and, you know, pass blocking was magnificent. You know, our quarterback had a bunch of time, and run blocking was, you know, there's holes everywhere, and it was just a really, really good effort by them.
Beginning of the game, that was actually our strategy, was obviously to get to the edge. You know, they had those big guys inside, but then our guys were able to start to handle them later on, and we were able to get the ball inside off tackle a little bit more for a while there. And then obviously they got some things going in the second half and got us on our heels a little bit.
First win of the season for the Cougars gives them confidence going into next week against a very good Lakeland team.
This first win, especially a home opener, it's a big confidence boost to everyone, but we got to keep on working. We have Lakeland next week, so we just got to get back to work, and hopefully we win that game.
I was talking to one guy at Clifton, and, you know, he was saying that they lost a lot of seniors too, and, you know, they're in the same boat we are, and, you know, we're going to bring this momentum, use it, work even harder next week, and, you know, keep this win streak going, hopefully.
I think it's really good for us confidence-wise. Lakeland is a good team. And I think our line is going to play well, because we can see that we can actually block people who are bigger than us. And then we'll get Cody back. So it's going to be a good game.
We got our work cut out for us next week with Lakeland. They're a good football team. But you know what? Our kids got, you know, some momentum back now. They're feeling pretty good about themselves. We're going to enjoy this for about 24 hours, and then we're going to get back to work.
All right, folks. You can watch MuggsMedia.com on our website in high definition. High definition right now. That means you can see every pimple I have on my face. I got pimples on my forehead, the lines on my face. By the way, did you watch Dancing with the Stars the other night? You see Ryan Lochley get attacked by that. My daughter watches that show. And Marsha Brady is on there. boy, I was disappointed. She's 60 years old. She aged a lot. A lot of wrinkles. What happened? What happened to her? Anyway, what happened to Franklin Sussex Auto Mall? We're still here, folks, waiting for your business. Come on, we'll sell you a car today. Let's take a commercial. Time out.
Bill Snopper here, and if you love big tailgate parties, you'll love the Monster Tailgate Sales Event at Franklin Sussex Auto Mall. With savings up to $10,000 off every new Jeep, Chrysler, Dodge, and Ram. Plus, with every purchase, you'll get a Coleman Excursion Grill. Get savings up to $10,000 off the dream car, truck, SUV you really want. And if you need credit help, we can cook it up for you and serve it well done. For Monster Tailgate Savings, hurry to Route 23 in Sussex.
Jeep Celebration Event, Ram Power Days.
When it comes to caring for the unexpected, take comfort in knowing that our emergency department is prepared and equipped to take care of all patients' needs, from minor injuries to more advanced life-threatening illnesses like heart attacks and strokes. No other provider can match the experience, commitment to quality, and access to state-of-the-art technology available at Newton Medical Center. And as part of Atlantic Health System, we're also the only facility seamlessly connected to all the resources and medical experts at Morristown Medical Center and our sister hospitals for the breadth of high-quality and nationally ranked services offered throughout our network.
Looking for the perfect sure-to-please gift? Visit Gala Florist, conveniently located in the Jefferson Diner Plaza, offering expert floral design for all occasions, everything from a beautiful bouquet of roses to stunning wedding flowers. Gala Florist also offers a wide selection of seasonal gifts, plants, fruit and gourmet baskets, handbags, and jewelry. Gala Florist combines artful arrangements with the freshest flowers, exceptional service, and worldwide delivery. Come shop Gala Florist next to the Jefferson Diner or visit online at galaflorist.com. Gala Florist, 973-288-1847.
Pop, 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 money, money. Pop, 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 money, money, money.
Use your phone to pay your friends. You can even pay the rent. Out to dinner, pay your buddy. Use your phone to pop your money.
Lakeland Bank's pop money, money. Pop, 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 money, money, money.
Pay the sitter, send a gift. It's real easy, you get my drift. You don't need checks, you don't need cash. Use pop money, it's so fast.
Lakeland Bank's pop, pop money, money. The easy way to pay people. Pop to it.
Pop, pop, pop.
The Moorville Agency. Providing insurance for towns, counties, schools, and public entities. The Moorville Agency, with over 30 years' experience in the field. The Moorville Agency. For more information, call George Moorville at 973-383-3110.
Attention high school athletes, weekend warriors, and seniors. Therapeutics Unlimited is a physical therapy and sports rehab provider. Therapeutics Unlimited also provides pediatrics and vestibular therapy. Therapeutics Unlimited uses cutting-edge technology for personal one-on-one physical therapy with the goal of getting the patient to a full and speedy recovery. Therapeutics Unlimited with four locations in Sussex and Morris counties. In Sussex, Sparta and Andover, in Morris County, Randolph and Morristown. For more information, visit turehab.com.
Welcome back to the Franklin Sussex Auto Mall, Franklin Sussex Hyundai Sports Beat. More football highlights, Morristown Beard against Sussex Tech.
This portion of a Sports Beat, sponsored by Eastern Propane, your local hometown propane dealer. Call 827-3000.
We go to Denton J. Quick Field on the campus of Sussex Tech, and with Mo Beard facing a 3rd-and-8, Taj Valentine turns on the Jets, cuts it upfield, and it's a 42-yard touchdown run, and Mo Beard has a 6-0 lead over Sussex Tech. Sussex Tech is facing a 3rd-and-4, and it's freshman Brendan Hall with the tough run and the 1st-and-10 for the Mustangs. And Hall gets a great block and takes it from 23 yards out for the score, and after the PAT from Bo Maroney, Sussex Tech leads 7-6. The Mustangs feature an arsenal of running backs. Here, watch Matt Aldrich take the pitch, and he cuts it upfield for a 34-yard run into Crimson territory. Second quarter we go, and Matt Aldrich finishes off the drive for the Mustangs with his 4-yard touchdown run, and Sussex Tech has a 14-6 lead. Morristown Beard has a talented quarterback in Declan Kelly as he keeps this one himself, and he weaves his way through the Sussex Tech defense all the way down the sideline to the 2-yard line for a 72-yard pickup. And Kelly finishes the drive here with the quarterback sneak
and we are tied at 14 midway through the second quarter. All right, Sussex Tech gets the ball back, and it's Matt Aldrich picking up the big block from Rich Hoffman, and he rumbles 13 yards into Morristown Beard territory. The Mustangs finish off the drive here as Tyler Crum finds Frank Hoffman on the screen, and he takes it in from 13 yards out, and the Mustangs have a 21-14 lead at the half. All right, third quarter we go. Morristown Beard is on the move, and it's Declan Kelly finding a wide-open Jack Cipriano for a 17-yard pickup into Mustang territory. And Kelly scores again here, this time from 4 yards out, and after the missed two-point conversion, Morristown Beard trails Sussex Tech 21-20 after three quarters. Great game. All right, fourth quarter we go, and Sussex Tech's on the move again, and Frank Hoffman takes the pitch and goes upfield, and he's taken down at the 25 after a terrific 31-yard run. And Hoffman finishes off the drive here as he takes the pitch to the outside, breaking all sorts of tackles as he gets into the end zone, and Sussex Tech now has a 7-point lead, 27-20. And the Mustangs put the cap on this win as Matt Aldridge breaks out for this huge 51-yard touchdown run, his second of the game, and Sussex Tech goes on to beat Morristown Beard by a final 34-20 to improve to 2-0 on the season.
I feel great. It's a big win. We're 2-0 now. That's the second season in a row. I mean, it's pretty hard filling Shaheem's shoes. He left last year. I came in this year and tried my best, but it's mostly the line. They're doing great.
We opened big holes today. Everyone ran through. We have two freshmen starting, Marshall and Roger. They stepped up this year to fill some gaps that we lost last year. Seniors Chase and Eric Jaworski and Tommy Lago and all those people over there. It's been really good. I'm helping them out on plays and such.
I feel awesome. You know, it's a great win. They're a good team. We outplayed them.
Other than the Highland Park game last year, this was probably one of the biggest wins we've had in the 6 years that we've been here. It was a tough bunch of kids. You know, they're young, but they're so tough. So, big win for us.
Coming back off an injury, you ran for two touchdowns. Tell me about today.
The injury stopped me last year, but it just gave me motivation to come back even better this year.
You had four running backs, rotating them, freshmen and seniors. How does that contribute to your game?
They all do something, you know, a little different. Frankie's our big guy, kind of our bull. Richie's another, you know, little bull. And then the two young kids that can just run by you, run over you, put their foot in the ground and get around you. They're just talented kids. It's certainly not anything we've done as coaches. They're just gifted.
You guys opened up the season 2-0. How do you guys feel about the rest of this year's season?
2-0 is a great start to the season. It's a team effort. We all work together. Very key plays that lead to the success of 2-0, and we have to keep going. And we think we're going to have a pretty good season this year. We want to go all the way, game week by week. That's how we play.
I feel like we're going to have a very successful season. It's looking strong. Our running game is strong. We got a lot of good players.
It's a process, and it's I've said it before. It's not, you know, not nearly where it needs to be, but everybody thought last year getting the playoffs, and you know it did set things up better for this year, but people kind of didn't think we'd be a very good football team this year, and I kind of disagreed with them. I thought maybe we might be a little bit better as a whole, and getting the state playoff game under our belt is great, and now it's something we got to strive for and get back, and then not just get there, we got to advance. That'd be nice to advance. And you know, I like these kids, man. They're just tough. You can't teach that or coach that. That's something you just got. And you saw them. They're not very big, but they're tough, man.
All right, Bobby Leach in that Tips and Toes commercial. Bobby, you're the only man who would do that for me. You're a solid guy. I've been a fan of yours since I covered you at Pope John, Bobby. He walks around with no shoes coaching. He's got a great staff there, you know. Guys like Todd Polterstorff and J.P. Beebe. All right, you're watching the world-famous Franklin Sussex Automall, Franklin Sussex Hyundai Sports Beat here on local channel 10, high definition, mugsmedia.com. Let's take a commercial timeout.
Bill Snopper here, and if you love big tailgate parties, you'll love the Monster Tailgate Sales Event at Franklin Sussex Automall, with savings up to $10,000 off every new Jeep, Chrysler, Dodge, and Ram. Plus, with every purchase, you'll get a Coleman Excursion Grill. Get savings up to 10 grand off the dream car, truck, SUV you really want. And if you need credit help, we can cook it up for you and serve it well done. For Monster Tailgate Savings, hurry to Route 23 in Sussex.
Jeep Celebration Event, Ram Power Days.
United Water is now Suez, safe, clean water for the communities they serve.
Sussex County Community College is a great place to branch out and figure out what suits you best and what fits you as an individual.
The array of classes that they offer was perfect.
Professors will go out of their way for you. They'll sit with you until you understand completely.
It was the right choice for me because it would save me money and I would be able to get all my gen eds done before moving on to a four-year university.
Visit us at sussex.edu to find out more. Sussex County Community College. Start here, go anywhere.
Are you looking for something new out of your grocery shopping experience? Sussex Meatpacking is here to help. For over 50 years, we've been bringing Sussex County the finest in meats and poultry. We are your hometown butcher shop with a full-service deli, fresh-cut meats daily, and a kitchen for all your catering needs. We also carry imported groceries, a large line of frozen products, including seafood. All the food you see here was made in our very own kitchen. So come on by or check us out online to see what Sussex Meatpacking can do for you.
Farmstead Golf and Country Club is the perfect place to host your event. Weddings, christenings, baby and bridal showers, and sports banquets. The staff at Farmstead will make your day a special one. The banquet facility overlooks their beautiful 27-hole golf course. Farmstead Golf and Country Club can also host your charity golf event. For more information on the Farmstead banquet facilities or to book your tee time, call 383-1666. Farmstead Golf and Country Club, located on Lawrence Road in Lafayette. Visit their website at farmsteadgolf.com.
Sussex Rural Electric wants to save you money. Beat the Peak is a program that helps us avoid buying extra power when a high usage event happens. If you participate, our technicians install equipment that limits the use of your water heater and air conditioner during times of high usage, typically a few hours on very hot days. There's no cost to you, and signing up your water heater gets you a $100 bill credit or gift card and a $2 bill credit per month. Central Air is a $50 bill credit or gift card and a $5 bill credit per month. Credit available June, July, and August. We can all work together to beat the peak by calling 875-5101 or emailing customerservice@sussexrec.com.
Welcome back to the Franklin Sussex Auto Mall, Franklin Sussex Hyundai Sports Beat. Malvin Prep, is that where Pope John went? Near Philadelphia. And Jordan Catelli went with him. He came back alive and well. What? Unfortunately? No, he's a good kid. Don't say that about Jordan. We love him. All right, let's take a look at the highlights of that game.
These highlights are being brought to you by Rev It Up, Auto and Maintenance Garage on Main Street in Sparta.
It's early first quarter action here at Malvern Prep, and taking the handoff for the Friars around the near side is Zach Fernandez, picking up 12 yards on the play before getting knocked out of bounds and a first down at the Pope John 27-yard line. Then a fourth down for the Friars, they would have to settle for this 49-yard field goal by Brandon Chiazza as he splits the uprights, and Malvern Prep has a 3-0 lead with 7:36 left to go here in the first quarter. Malvern Prep is back on the attack, but it's the Pope John defense coming up big here as Joe Quintadamo jumps the route, making the pick on the near side, and the Lions take over first and 10 on the Friar 42. And the very next play from scrimmage, the give is to Christian Eisen as he takes it around the far side for a 13-yard gain and a Pope John first down. The Lions have to settle for three here as Vincent Antoniello knocks through his 24-yard field goal to tie the game at three at the end of the first quarter. All right, we move to the second quarter now, and it's Malvern Prep leading 8-3 after a safety and field goal, and it's Pope John on the move as it's Burrell Neal on the carry up the middle as he breaks through tackles and carries defenders with him for a 20-yard pickup and a Pope John first down. All right, Pope John has it fourth and goal from the 2-yard line with just seconds remaining. And off the bootleg, it's Ty Hironico keeping it himself as he walks in untouched for the touchdown. And Pope John has an 11-8 lead after a 2-point conversion heading into the half. All right, folks, third quarter now. The score is 11-8 Pope John. Until on this 3rd-and-3, it's Malvern Prep's Kevin Doyle hooking up with Tyge Leach down the middle for a 53-yard hookup and the touchdown as it's now 15-11 Malvern Prep with 8:53 left to go here in the third. Pope John will come right back down the field and answer, though, with a score of their own here as on 3rd-and-long, Ty Hironico looks for the end zone and finds Brian Dolan for the 19-yard touchdown pass, and it's now 17-15 Pope John leading heading into the fourth quarter. All right, Malvern Prep would retake the lead here, though, as Kevin Doyle would hit Quincy Watson in the flat as he breaks a tackle and stays on his feet across the goal line and score the touchdown to make it 21-17 Friars after a failed two-point conversion. It's 21-17 with 6:13 left in the fourth quarter. All right, the Lions wouldn't go away here, though, as Ty Hironica keeps it himself on the ground and takes it himself and finds nothing but open daylight in front of him as he goes the distance 53 yards to the end zone and this back-and-forth battle as Pope John up 24-21 with just over 3.5 remaining in the ballgame. All right, but Melbourne Prep would not go away as they make one final stand here as Kevin Doyle finds Mike Fay open in the flat as he's able to shed a tackle and rumble 40 yards down to the Pope John 23-yard line where it's 1st and 10 Friars with 2:20 remaining in the contest. All right, the Friars and Kevin Doyle end the comeback here successfully as he hits Matt Dowler in the back of the end zone for the 16-yard hookup and the go-ahead touchdown. And that would prove to be the difference, folks, as Melbourne Prep goes on to defeat the Lions 28-24 in a thriller as Pope John falls to 1-1 heading to Del Barton next weekend.
You know, obviously, the first game we played well. We played home. This was a travel game, 3 hours. You know, it's a good program. They know how to compete. You know, our guys got after it, but we just shot ourselves in the foot way too many times, you know.
And you guys had a great touchdown at the end of the half, at the end of the first half here. Ty taking it around the corner on a bootleg pass to give you guys the lead heading into the second half. You guys had all the momentum. What was the mindset coming out for the third quarter?
Yeah, we knew it was going to be another 24 minutes of real hard football, you know what I mean? And it was. And went back and forth. And, you know, at the end we just didn't make some plays that we should have. You know, we left too many opportunities, you know.
The defense played well in the first half, just limited to a couple field goals, kept out of the end zone through the first two quarters. What do you think of the defense despite giving up the final touchdown at the end of the game?
Yeah, our defense played great in the first half, Our defense played great in the first half. Our offense was nowhere to be found. The second half, our offense started to get it going right, like you said, the last drive. And then, you know, we just didn't hold them at the end. So, you know, we got to put it together. We left a point up on an extra point. So, I mean, we got a lot of things to clean up. But the kids competed. I'm, you know, proud of them, and we're going to get ready for Del Barton.
All right, Mark Unglob. I see you when I'm walking every day. Mark gives me the wave. I hope he doesn't stop, he's saying. Mark owns the Unglob agency over there in Sparta. Some guy almost ran me over the other day. I should have got your license plate. You got to slow down when people are walking on the road, pal. Anyway, Mark Unglob sponsors our top five as we go into a break.
Bill Snopper here, and if you love big tailgate parties, you'll love the Monster Tailgate Sales Event at Franklin Sussex Auto Mall. With savings up to $10,000 off every new Jeep, Chrysler, Dodge, and Ram. Plus, with every purchase, you'll get a Coleman Excursion Grill. Get savings up to $10,000 off the dream car, truck, SUV you really want. And if you need credit help, we can cook it up for you and serve it well done. For Monster Tailgate Savings, hurry to Route 23 in Sussex.
Jeep Celebration Event, Ram Power Days.
Hi, I'm Kurt from KG Companies. KG Companies has been serving Sussex County for over 27 years. We provide solar, electric, and general contracting services for both commercial and residential projects. As an employer and a parent of student athletes, I appreciate the life lessons sports teaches our young people. I want to recognize and thank all the teachers, coaches, and parents that promote and make high school athletics possible here at Veritas and throughout the county.
Sussex County Community College is a great place to branch out and figure out what suits you best and what fits you as an individual.
The array of classes that they offer was perfect.
Professors will go out of their way for you. They'll sit with you until you understand completely.
It was the right choice for me because it would save me money and I would be able to get all my gen eds done before you're moving on to a four-year university.
Visit us at sussex.edu to find out more. Sussex County Community College. Start here, go anywhere.
Pop, 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 money, money. Pop, 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 money, money, money.
Use your phone to pay your friends. You can even pay the rent. Out to dinner, pay your buddy. Use your phone to pop your money.
Lakeland Banks, pop money, money. Pop, 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 money, money, money.
Pay the sitter, send a gift. It's real easy, you get my drift? You don't need checks, you don't need cash. Use Pop Money, it's so fast.
Lakeland Bank's Pop Money, the easy way to pay people. Pop to it.
Hi, I am State Farm Agent Alex Aguado. My office here in Sparta, New Jersey, consists of 6 insurance professionals with over 50 years experience. We consider it a privilege to help meet your needs. So please take a moment and send us an email or give us a call. Thank you, and we look forward to hearing from you soon.
Need an affordable used vehicle like now?
Don't panic, see Dave Franek.
Dave Franek Automotive is located on Route 565 in Wantage. For a complete inventory of the vehicles they have on sale at Dave Franek, go to DaveFranekAuto.com or call them at 875-3807. And always remember, don't panic. See Dave Franek.
All right, folks, welcome back to the Franklin Sussex Auto Mall, Franklin Sussex Hyundai Sports Beat here on Local Channel 10. And if you're watching us on the website right now, you're watching us in HD on mugsmedia.com. You can now watch us on Smart TV by going to subscribe to our Mugs Media YouTube page, and you can watch the show on your Smart TV. And we're going to have an app very soon to watch the program. So as we continue to keep up with the times here on Mugs Media, mugsmedia.com, as we broadcast to you from Franklin Sussex Auto Mall, the only choice you need. Big matchup in field hockey, Walk Hill Valley and High Point. And I want to thank a special sponsor for that game, the folks over there at D.W. Clark Buses Company. And let's take a look at the highlights of that game.
This portion of a Sports Beat is sponsored by Tire King, behind the AMP in Sussex, where everyone can afford to retire. Tire King now does brakes as well. Tire King, tell Charles Kaparis Muggsy sent me. Walk in there and yell out, Tire King. The phone number is 875-5950.
First half action here at High Point, and Wilkie Valley has a corner, and it's high-scoring Morgan Carr with the shot, but it's Brittany McKenna with the save for High Point, and we have no score. Now watch High Point get the ball into the circle, but it's Wilkie Valley goalie Samantha Hutnick with the saves here to keep High Point out of the cage. Then High Point sends in another shot on goal, and once again Samantha Hutnick makes the stop to keep this game scoreless at the half. Second half we go, now watch Hutnick do it again as she stops Kelsey Little on the doorstep with a terrific save, and we still have no score. Alright, High Point's back in the circle, and the ball bounces to Tyra Wingle, who bangs it home for the goal 10 minutes into the second half, and High Point has the 1-0 lead. Walk Hill Valley's on the move, and it's Morgan Carr with the blast, and Brittany McKenna makes the save as the ball goes wide of the cage, and it stays 1-0 High Point. High Point gets another opportunity here on this shot from Marissa Sinicor, but Walk Hill Valley goalie Samantha Hutnick makes the save for the Rangers. High Point's looking to get that all-important insurance goal here as Julianne Mangano takes the shot on Hutnick, who makes the save again for the Rangers to keep them in the game. All right, High Point gets another opportunity, and it's Kelsey Little getting robbed again by Hutnick as she makes the stop, but High Point would post the 1-0 shutout victory, the third shutout of the season, as they move to 2-0-1.
Felt really good. We played them in a scrimmage about a week ago, and we beat them in the very last second of the game, 1-0. So it felt really good to beat them again and just justify that we're the better team.
I'm really proud of our team. We really worked together. And between like the defense, midfielders, offense, and like our goalie, we all just worked really well to get the ball down the field and into the back of the net for like another great win against Walk Hill, one of our biggest rivals.
I think we played well together. We really had like an ambition to get it down the field, and we got it in the last scrimmage. We had it the last second, so we really wanted to get that first goal and stick with it.
I honestly think it was a really great game. Coming back from Lenape 0-0, we knew that we really had to push getting the ball into the cage. And coming back from Walk Hill, beating them in the last second in our scrimmage, we knew that we had to score fast in order to get the momentum. And I think we did that really well today in the second half.
I was really pleased after yesterday's missed opportunity to play, but dangerous and inclement weather. So I was really pleased with how we rebounded today. They're a phenomenal program also, and we always play them even.
High Point had the better of the play in the first half, but couldn't find the back of the cage. Second half, they came out strong, and Tyra Wingle got a big goal 10 minutes in to turn things around.
it just felt really good to get that goal. You know, like, it's not just one person that gets that goal. It's the whole team. It's the events that lead up to it. So it's not just one person. It's everybody.
I think we knew that when we didn't score in the first half that it was really important to score in the second half. So we just, like, really pushed through and got, like, excited and, like, hyped during halftime to score.
I think one of the things as a coach you're always hoping for is we had opportunities in the first half, and their goalie did a nice job, but we just persevered. And I'm really pleased with the fact that I have a great coaching staff who also is really helping. We have some great volunteers that are helping, and it's really making us a tight-knit group.
High Point's defense was spectacular again today. Three games this year, no goals allowed.
We're just all heart. Like, it's just all, like, power, and, like, we just want to get it out of there. It's just the urge to get it out of that circle and just get it up the field.
I think our offense is really good at coming back and supporting our defense, and we have a really strong defensive line and sweeper that just, when the ball gets back there, they just get it out wide, and it just goes up the field again.
I think that we have a lot of chemistry. We've played together since we were freshmen, and then we all kind of took our own path, but now we're back here as seniors, and we have a really strong defensive line this year, and we're really working hard during practice, and we work during preseason, like, really getting it out and getting it back up to the forward line.
We've been priding ourselves in taking opportunities to make sure we're playing good defense and transitioning onto offense with great passing, good team chemistry, which a lot of the girls talked about, but also really looking for who's wide open. So we're scanning the field really well.
Last year, High Point got off to a bit of a rocky start to the season, only winning 7 games for the entire year. But this year, they have 2 wins and 1 tie to Lenape Valley. They beat a good Pingree team, and today they beat a very good Walk Hill Valley team.
Yeah, last year we started off a little rough, so this year we wanted to really come in strong, and we're losing a lot of seniors this year, so they all wanted to, finish their season a good season. So
I think we just worked a lot harder this year in preseason, and we're just really, like, a big team, and we have good chemistry this year, and we're just focusing on making it all the way through towards states.
I'm really excited because I think preseason we worked very hard this year. We knew coming in that we have, like, really good potential to have good chemistry, and the fact that we started, even though we tied Lenape 0-0, beating Pingree was a really good momentum for us, and now beating Walk Hill 1-0, I'm really excited to see what this team has to offer this year.
Yeah, I think that what we're doing is realizing last year, and now starting fresh and really getting going right away.
All right, folks, here we are at the world-famous Franklin Sussex Auto Mall. Oh, if you're a football fan, I got to throw this in, and you want to travel to Morris County, our sister dealership, Nielsen Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram, is hosting Lawrence Taylor for a free autograph session on Saturday, September 24th. For you Sussex people who want to go over the border to Morris, you have an opportunity now to meet Lawrence Taylor. I don't know. I'm not driving him there. What are you asking me for? Anyway, let's take a commercial timeout.
Bill Snopper here, and if you love big tailgate parties, you'll love the Monster Tailgate Sales event at Franklin Sussex Auto Mall. With savings up to $10,000 off every new Jeep, Chrysler, Dodge, and Ram. Plus, with every purchase, you'll get a Coleman Excursion Grill. Get savings up to $10,000 off the dream car, truck, SUV you really want. And if you need credit help, we can cook it up for you and serve it well done. For Monster Tailgate Savings, hurry to Route 23 in Sussex.
Jeep Celebration Event, Ram Power Days.
Sussex County Community College is a great place to branch out and figure out what suits you best and what fits you as an individual.
The array of classes that they offer was perfect.
Professors will go out of their way for you. They'll sit with you until you understand completely.
It was a right choice for me because it would save me money and I would be able to get all my gen eds done before you're moving on to a four-year university.
Visit us at sussex.edu to find out more. Sussex County Community College. Start here, go anywhere.
Green Valley Farms, with locations in Sussex County and Pike County, Pennsylvania. Green Valley Farms supplies local restaurants with the best beef. Green Valley Farms has homemade ice cream and the freshest produce. Owners Joy and Deuce Talamay are old-time farmers. Green Valley Farms. Check them out on Facebook. American Federal Mortgage knows shopping for a mortgage can be stressful. They have the lowest rates in the nation with their state-approved lock and loan form. American Federal Mortgage has great customer service to answer your questions and concerns. They will get you into the home of your dreams. For more information, call 888-321-HOUSE or go to njmortgage.com.
First words. Meaningful signs and foreign languages. Learning sounds like fun. First steps, new challenges, and happy dances. Learning develops by leaps and bounds. Early scribbles, swirls of creativity, and strokes of genius. Learning is all around the Goddard School. Good choice.
Party time or work time? Tri-State Rentals has the right tools and supplies for your next job or party. Event and wedding tents in many sizes, plus all the accessories you need to host that perfect party, including bounce houses, carnival games, and catering supplies. We also rent tools and equipment for any job, big or small, indoor or out. We rent, sell, and service Kubota tractors. Planning your next job or event just got easier. Visit Tri-State Rentals online at tristaterentals.com or visit our showroom, 105 Sparta Avenue, Newton.
Welcome back to the Franklin Sussex Auto Mall, Franklin Sussex Hyundai Sports Beat. The Orthopedic Institute of New Jersey presents the Play of the Week.
We go to Kittatinny High School and watch Josh Klimek of the Cougars take it around the end. You think the play's over? No, Klimek stays on his feet and he scores the incredible 16-yard touchdown run to give Kittatinny a 6-0 lead, and that is our Football Play of the Week.
It's now time for our good friends Eli and Henry over there at Sussex Meat.
Hello, Henry. Sussex Meat Packing. Yeah, we can do that. What time? Okay.
This doesn't sound like Henry, does it? Okay. Doesn't sound anything like him, but he sponsors, and his son Eli over there at Sussex Meat Packing, they sponsor a soccer field hockey play of the week.
Let's go to High Point High School. No score, second half, but that changes here. Watch Tyra Wingle of High Point put it in the back of the cage to help High Point top Wokeel Valley 1-0, and that is our soccer field hockey play of the week.
Parisi Speed School is the number one speed school in the entire state of New Jersey, run by our friend Steve Leo. And Parisi Speed School sponsors the male and female athletes of the week.
Let's give the female athlete of the week to Sparta girls soccer goalie Leah Gashion, who posted her third and fourth shutouts of the season last week in 2-0 wins over Mount Olive and Morris Hills. Hey, Leah Gashion, you are the female athlete of the week. Let's give the male athlete of the week to Troy DuPont of Lenape Valley's football team. He rushed for over 100 yards and scored 3 touchdowns to help Lenape Valley to an impressive 38-15 win over Newton. Hey, Troy DuPont, you are the male athlete of the week.
Parisi Speed School, always taking new people into their school, located in Sparta, New Jersey. Parisi Speed School, home of the number one speed school in the area. Okay, thank you very much, Steve Leo, for sponsoring the Male and Female Athlete of the Week, and thank all our sponsors. If you want to be a sponsor, send me an email, Jerry, J-E-R-R-Y, at mugsmedia.com. We'll get you hooked up right away. Always looking for new and exciting sponsors. Welcome in Mountain Creek. Coming on with us in November. We're excited. Mountain Creek, all right? The number one ski area in the entire Northwest region. I'm talking about Pennsylvania. Mountain Creek is number one. And they have ski clubs there. Mountain Creek will be a new sponsor here on the Sports Beat. We love those guys. I'm going to Oktoberfest. I got a couple of free passes. Does that include everything when you go there, Dan? No, you don't know, huh? I hope it does. I don't want to spend any money. I'm cheap. Anyway, speaking of cheap, I better wrap this up. From the world-famous Franklin Sussex Auto Mall, we bid you a hearty good night.